Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my larger InDesign course on my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Okay, so we need to save a JPEG out, ready for some purpose. You might be sticking it into a PowerPoint presentation or a Word document, or sending it to a website to be used as part of a WordPress CMS, something. Okay, you need a JPEG or a PNG, same principle works. The one thing I'd say is that often a PDF will work as well. Okay, if I'm putting it into Word or PowerPoint, a PDF will go in. The nice thing about PDFs is that the quality is always a lot better, especially for type. Okay, but if you have to use a JPEG, let's do it this way. Let's go to File, Export, same as a PDF. And down the bottom here, where it used to say Adobe PDF, go down to either JPEG or PNG. Super easy. Okay, and I'm going to give it the same name, but I'm going to make a high-res version, high-resolution, high-quality one. You can call it what you like. Hit save. I'm saving it into that folder on my desktop. All pages, I'm going to do pages. We haven't done any spreads yet. We'll look at that later. And then the quality. Okay, and you've got two things that kind of really control what it looks like, quality and the resolution. Quality will be how pixelated it is, okay, how like what the, is it a bit scrappy and a bit yucky looking? And medium will still look fine, low will look gross, never use low, but medium will be fine, high will be pretty amazing, and maximum, you won't see the difference between these two, I promise. Okay, so we're gonna go for a high res one, maximum. Okay, so it's gonna look as good as it can be, but the file size is gonna be quite big. And then resolution here, the lowest is 72 and the highest you wanna go to is 300. Anything past this, this thing's gonna be absolutely big, like meters wide. So we're gonna go 300. Color space is RGB, okay? Always gonna be RGB for a JPEG and leave this stuff at the bottom. Let's click export. Nothing really happens. You gotta go and find that folder and there's my high res. He's 1.4 megabytes. It's pretty big, okay? But you look at the quality. Pretty awesome, okay, beautiful. So let's do the version. Let's say I'm sending it out and it's gonna go up onto a website, and I know that 1.4 megabytes is far too big for our website, so, or emailing even, it's pretty big. So we're gonna go to export, and we're gonna say make something really small, okay, I'm gonna give it a name, I'm gonna call it low res, okay, and I'm gonna go through and say maximum, I'm gonna put it down to like high, let's do medium, okay, and, this is the kind of lowest you ever want to go, 72 at medium. Click export. And you'll notice that the high res version, I'll make this a little bigger. I'll even make it a little bigger. Okay, so 1.4 is the high res, and see this one here, kilobytes? So that is 0.04 instead of 1.4, so it's tiny compared to it. And look at the quality, it's smaller, the quality is fine. It's not gonna win the quality awards, but this one here is really big, but really big file size. So probably somewhere in the middle, right? Just find yours, go to 150 DPI and go to maximum, see what the size is. Another thing you might find is that if you don't have any images, okay, say it's just block colors, your file size is gonna be a lot smaller because it doesn't have to deal with all of these colors. If you've got hundreds of images, it's gonna be even bigger than 1.4. Cool, so that, my friends, is how to save a JPEG from InDesign. Let's get on to the next video. So, what did you think? Did you like it? Okay, if you did, please hit the like button and maybe consider subscribing to my channel. It really helps my business. Now, this is just a free video from my larger InDesign course. You can see the full version on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site, there is a free cheat sheet you can download. Okay, print it off. Stick it next to your computer, look awesome. The other thing is I have lots of other courses there. Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, After Effects, Premiere, Dreamweaver, lots of other ones. So go check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye.